Hello. We're going to do a quick video today for July 4th, the hazards that you may not be aware of. July 4th for cops has always been a trying time. And a lot of things happen that some of it's unbelievable. I'll stick to the civilized stuff the best I can. People do bad things. Like if people go out and get the stuff in the stores, depending on what state, how many fireworks you can get. From here it doesn't take long to go to other states and get fireworks and bring them here. A lot of people make homemade fireworks, which are very, very dangerous. And they're not experts on explosives and stuff like that. So don't touch any fireworks. You don't know if it's good stuff. You don't know if the fuses are good. A lot of people have lost fingers in their hands with the old M80 firecrackers. They look like a little piece of dynamite. And sometimes the fuse is just too fast, where you can throw it, blows your hands up. Face off. I've seen some nasty stuff with a cop. You gotta be very, very careful with these explosives, because you don't know where the people got them or what they're doing. And some, you know, people aren't bad people, they just don't have a good time, but they've been drinking, they got explosives that aren't tested or aren't safe. They bring them to events, you got little kids there. So kind of stay back where you have a lot of space from strangers. You're with your family, you're probably okay. I'll give you a few examples of stuff that happened, because I'm going to keep this short. One of the things that was most interesting to me is when I was working as a street cop in this out west, they had a real big park in the middle of the city. Nice park, very nice display, and very good fireworks. Well, during the fireworks, one of the neighbors that's outside the park, lives in the area, took his 44 Magnum out. He thought it would be okay to shoot one up in the air. We shoot a gun up in the air, bullet goes up, guess what? The bullets come back down. Now, I know a lot of kids today that don't take math very well. Acceleration of gravity is this, what is it, what's the acceleration, I don't ever tell what it is. S equals 1/2 ht². That's what it is, acceleration of gravity. So once it dies, it accelerates, basically 16 feet per second the first starts, but you know, the weight of the bullet, it comes whipping back down. Now, if it comes whipping back down, 9 out of 10 times, 999 out of 1,000 times, probably not going to hit anybody. But this particular day, a guy got shot at the park. Well, then the investigation started. So they put on TV, if anybody saw a neighbor shooting up in the air, please call. We'd have to go out and sweep the area with all the calls and complaints, talk to the people, see where we are in relation to the park and what direction they were shooting in relation to where the park was, but where the guy was shooting. The one good tip from one of the neighbors said, guys, yeah, shoot this pistol. You know what caliber at that time. The bullet was pulled out of the victim. He didn't die, but he was pretty injured. And the one guy that shot, went over and talked to him. He said a 44 Magnum shot in the air. He thought it was okay. So, confiscated the gun, took it to the lab. We had the bullet that hit the person. Now we test his bullet and they matched. So he was the one that did it. Not a bad guy, no criminal record. Just young, dumb, and stupid. They all seem to come that way. When you're in the military, at that time. Well, I shouldn't say all, but a lot of, because of the drinking. And people think it's safe. That's one of the things that happened. Another thing that happened that was really bad, I remember. The tubes that they launched the fireworks for, you're supposed to be staying away. They got things around, stay out of the area. Well, when the display was done, these weren't the same year, I don't think. These two incidents. And some guy was standing right next to the tube. He thought it was empty. For some reason, he lit a cigarette. I can't remember if he had a cigar or mouth or just plain stupid. Dropped it in the tube, the thing exploded and burned him real bad. So you got to be careful because the stuff, all of the things that they fire up, that don't always go off. There might be 10 things, 9 might go up, and that one's still loaded. And he walked over there, dropped his match in there, and kaboom. So that's two things that I'm talking about that I have very close contact with, and it didn't work out very good. Now, what you have to worry about where you live at, depends on whether you're in the city, country, or in between, are people like to get us shooting up in the air. Now, rifles are more powerful, so they go higher, and that means they'll come down harder. But the difference between a handgun, a lot of handguns, not all, a lot of handguns are below the speed of sound, which is like, what, 1150 feet per second, somewhere in that neighborhood, depends on the altitude, temperature, and all that sort of thing. But in that ballpark, and anything breaks the speed of sound, you get a crack or boom. It's distinct to us shooters, cops, military guys, hunters. They can tell when a high-powered rifle is going off versus a .22 because of that sound, that crack sound. Like, I've been on a mountain or somebody from the other mountain out west shot towards me, not at me, I don't think. Probably is an animal close to me or something. And what you hear is crack, boom, the sound catches up. If you're at the receiving end of the bullet, it's crack, boom. The reason I'm telling you this, if you're home tomorrow night, well, this is Monday, it's Tuesday, it's the 4th, and you hear a firework go off, it's usually going, all you're going to hear is boom. Now, if somebody's shooting their gun off, what you're going to hear is crack, boom, what I'm just talking about. If you hear that, definitely call the police, because somebody is shooting a high-velocity gun, which is very unsafe. If you know who it is, tell them, here it is, point it out, make sure they clear that and make it safe. You know, they might not necessarily arrest the guy, but they'll confiscate his gun, and if he's drunk, they'll probably put him in detox so he doesn't keep doing that, make the neighborhood safe. But when the crack gets there before the boom, you are at the pointing end of the gun. Trust me on this. Now, other things that happen during these celebrations, you always have a certain percentage of people, mainly men, they go out looking for trouble. Depending on their age bracket, 1 to 18, they want to bump shoulders, show how tough they are, might get the fisticuffs and sort of thing like that. Then you might get somebody that's, you know, 25 to 35, that aren't like the young kids, but they're out looking for women, selling drugs, you know, back and forth, stuff like that. And that can become an issue because somebody didn't pay them enough money, or somebody beat them up, stole their drugs. All that kind of stuff happens on these parades. Because you attract people, people are customers to a drug dealer, and people that want to buy the drugs don't want to pay it, and they figure this guy looks like a punk and he's easy to get the drugs off, and it could be a mess. So if you see stuff going on with people in that age bracket or exchanging stuff or something like that, go to the other part of the parade. The stuff can come out like that. And it's not like the old days where they had stuff, but not as much. You know, the 60s and stuff. They're still selling drugs and doing different things. But they weren't being as aggressively criminal as it appears to be today. You got to remember that today, and then, you have a right to own a gun. But with rights comes responsibility. You got a right to own a gun, but you're responsible for it and anything that happens with it. You have a right to drive a car. But with that, you can't be driving drunk and running people over. And at these big parades, fireworks, 4th of July, people get run over, they get drunk, and I just told you, some of them get shot. So if you're seeing people who are doing what they're allowed to do, they have the rights, but they don't seem like they have the responsibility for what they're doing, my advice to you, put distance between you. And just remember, if something goes down, you hear a lot of shots. Okay, I'm going to say something to you, and I don't want you to take this as racist. But have you ever noticed in these mass shootings, you show the victims? You don't see as many minorities as you do people who aren't minorities when they show them on the news the victims. Because a lot of the minorities come from areas where it might be a little bit rougher, some not, but a high percentage may. As soon as they hear a shot, see you tomorrow, I'll check the news. Then you got the people come out, What's going on out here?
Whoa.
Don't be the what's going on out here. Here's some shots. Whatever direction looks the clearest, you're in a track meet. And watch the news tomorrow. So be safe. Be careful. You see anybody throwing something on the ground that's fizzing like it has a fuse? Oh, one more thing. I was in an area close to a military base. And they have grenade simulators. So like half a stick of dynamite, quarter stick of dynamite. Very powerful, like a giant M80. And they were driving around town every four, because the GIs would be training, but they keep some for themselves. And they could sell them and stuff like that. If they threw them in your yard, you threw an M80 in the yard, you get a hole in the grass about this big. Okay? These M80s, these grenade simulators, blow a hole this big in the grass. They're nasty. So those are dangerous. And they just ride around, throw them out the window. Probably, depends on where you live, they may not have access to it, might not happen, but you have to keep that in mind. If people get a hold of stuff that they normally don't get a hold of for the rest of the year, because people do have them, want to make a few bucks, you know, spend on their girlfriend, buy some drugs, put some gas in the car, whatever. So anything that looks suspicious during a holiday is suspicious. Have a great holiday. Keep your eyes open, your running shoes on, and don't be stupid. Just like Forrest said, stupid is as stupid does. Happy Independence Day.